Hey y'all, and welcome back to Morgan's Beauty Corner. In today's video, we are going to be discussing my holy grail products, products that I could not live without, products that I've been using for a long time, or some of them maybe I just started using maybe within the past 4 months and I'm just obsessed with them. So we're going to discuss all these products today. And I'm going to try to make this video as short and sweet as possible. Now, some of these products, as far as like categories, I have multiple. So, again, we're going to hurry it along as fast as possible. And I am going to go in the order in which I typically do my makeup. So, typically, starting out, what I do first is my brows. And originally, I preferred precisely my brow pencil, and on accident, I ordered the Goof Proof Brow Pencil, and this has become a staple, a holy grail. I am more of a pencil gal, and I think that is totally up to preference, whether you prefer pencil, or you prefer powder, or you prefer pomade. I think it just depends on your preference and, you know, whatever it is that your look that you are going for, look you're trying to achieve, or whatever is just easiest and best for you. So for me, it is the Goof Proof Brow Pencil. I think that Benefit kills it when it comes to brow products and also pore filling primer. Now, I don't set my brow right after I pencil my brow in. Typically, I cut my brow first, but as long as we're sitting here talking about brow products, we might as well go ahead and mention the two brow gels that I use. Now, I do use a brow gel that is tinted, and then I use a clear brow gel. So on the tail of my brow, about halfway back to the tail, I use the Gimme Brow, also by Benefit. Also, guys, I do just want to mention now, ignore my nails and ignore my spray tan. And then in the front part of my brow, I just go through with brow setter, and then after this is the 24-hour brow setter by Benefit. It is amazing. Your brows will not budge. Now, what I typically do after I have finished all of my makeup is I'll go back in with the Benefit 24-hour brow setter and just go back through all of my brows. Now, again, as I did mention previously, after I pencil in my brows, what I then do is I go ahead and cut my brow. Now, while we're on the topic of concealers, I'm just going to go ahead and talk about the two concealers that I use for my under eye and to cut my brow, because I do use concealers to do that. So, the concealer that I use to cut my brow and my top concealer that I like to use underneath the eye is the Kevin Kwan. This is the Sensual Skin Enhancer concealer, and I'm showing you this upside down, I think. No, I was right the first time. Kevin Kwan, and this is in SX01. This is full coverage. This is for full glam, full beat. It is thick, so a little bit does go a long way. If you have drier skin like me, what I always do is use a oil primer, or not an oil primer, I just use a face oil before I put my primer on. And that always makes it easier for all of your creams to blend into the skin. Now, for touching up any imperfections on my face, I have really bad high pigmentation on my cheeks. I have rosacea, so I do like to spot conceal before I put on my foundation. And for that, I think this is, without saying, Tarte Shape Tape. If this isn't in your makeup collection, then you really are, you know, your makeup kit isn't exactly where it could be. This concealer is just absolutely beautiful. I love this concealer so much. And it is a, you know, liquid concealer, so it is a lot thinner than the Kevin Kwan. Now, after I do cut my brows, I go ahead and put my eyeshadow primer on. And typically for me, if I'm going to be totally honest, my holy grail would be the Anastasia eyeshadow primer. But I had this one sent to me. This is Pretty Vulgar. This is the eyeshadow primer by Pretty Vulgar. And this was a beautiful surprise because I have actually really enjoyed it. And now, while I must say that I typically do like a lighter toned eyeshadow base. This is more on the cream beige side, and I like it so much. It literally makes your shadows to their highest pigment. They blend like a dream. It is underneath this Cut Crease Today, and I love it. So yeah, pretty vulgar. Eyeshadow primer is awesome, and my ultimate holy grail would be the Anastasia eyeshadow primer. Now obviously after we prime the lid, we go ahead and we do our shadows. So I do have a palette that I'm going to mention that it seems like it is my favorite palette of 2020 already. I also have a glitter palette that is my ultimate favorite glitters that I've ever used. And I also have some shimmer shades that I'm also going to talk about. So we'll go ahead and start with the shimmer shade. So I just made an order with Ulta to order more of these. These are the ColourPop Super Shock Shadows. These are so good. They're just so pigmented. They're so beautiful. This is in the shade Amaze, which is like a gold undertone. One of my favorites. And my second most favorite is... this is Birthday Wish, and I'm not sure if... Well, there you go. Beauty Light's kind of showing the reflective now. It has like purple and blue reflective in it. It is so beautiful. They are so powerful, so pigmented. You do not need any setting spray. If you really want to take it there, you can, but my preferred method with these ColourPop Super Shock Shadows are to just go in with my finger and pat them on the lid. I feel like that gets the ultimate pigment out of them. Now, also from ColourPop is my favorite glitters that I have ever used. And I'm saying this because I do not typically have to use a glitter glue when using, well, never. For myself, I wouldn't. Now, if I was doing a client, obviously, I would use glitter glue just so that their look does last the absolute longest. But I have never had any issues with this glitter and not having any glitter glue. So I am going to show you this here. This did come out earlier this year. You do get the Z palette, and then you get to pick what shades that you want in it. Honestly, I've kind of like kicked myself in the butt, and I don't know why I haven't went back on ColourPop site and just went ahead and gotten the rest of the shades. I should have just went ahead and got them all because it was such a good deal, and for some reason I didn't. But these are crazy pigmented. Like what you see in the pan, put it on your eye. Like it is so good. You can literally, I've went in with liner brushes and done, you know, cut the top of the crease with it. I mean, I've done everything. I've put these over shadows. I have left them by themselves. I've put them on the lower lash line. I've done so much with these glitters, and as you can see, they are still holding in great. I mean, obviously the palette's a little messy, but I mean, it's been used, so what do you really expect? But when you're looking for a glitter, especially if you're just starting out, this is the way to go. And this palette with all these shades, I believe, was like $24. So I mean, you're not gonna find, like, that's such a good deal. ColourPop is really a way to go when it comes with shadows, when it comes to blushes, when it comes to their highlights. Like, they are so reasonably priced. And their liquid lipsticks, which we'll mention here soon. They're just so reasonably priced, and it's good product. So that's a win-win for me. So now I'm gonna go ahead and mention the palette that has literally been on my eyes. If you've seen a picture I've posted, if you've seen me out and about and I've had my makeup on, which is always typically full glam, it has been this palette right here. This is the Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 X. This is Jaclyn Hill X Morphe Volume 2 palette. And honestly, I mean, I was pretty much prepared for it to be killer because her first palette was like amazing. So, I mean, I really wasn't expecting anything less. And plus, when it comes to Morphe, anytime I have somebody new in makeup or somebody who, you know, is starting to build up their kit, message me and say, Morgan, what would you suggest as far as shadows? What would you suggest me go get to build up my kit? I always say, go to Morphe, go on their website, pick out a few palettes that looks like, you know, don't like buy the same looking palette over and over again, but buy you like 3 to 4, depending on if you buy the smaller ones or big ones. You know, buy you a few of them with different ranges of shades. Go to checkout and use literally any of the biggest beauty gurus you can think of. Use their name at checkout. Save you some coin. Then go to ColourPop website and get you, you know, your glitters, your shimmers, things like that. Like, there is good quality makeup by Morphe that is really, it spoke about a lot, but I really feel like because of all the hype, some people are scared to go out and really go there. But I'm telling you right now that these shadows are bomb. It's on my eyes right now. This is the palette. Now, this palette has been used and it has been loved, and I'm not going back and cleaning my dabbling palette, but this is the palette right here. As you can see, there is a variety of shades, from neutrals that you could wear every day. You go down into your reds and your corals and your oranges. You've got you a bright yellow. This bone shade right here, this Y, is called Certified. That is the most beautiful, most pigmented white I have ever, I mean, it is, it changes the game. Then you've got your pinks, your purples, your reds, your maroons, your brown, your blacks, your, I mean, you've got a variety of different options. These shimmer shades in here are really, really good. They're really reflective. That gold right there literally looks like you have, like, cut a piece of gold off and just slapped it on your lid. I mean, this palette is absolutely gorgeous. It's $40, but again, you can go on the website of Morphe, put in, you know, Jacqueline Hill, Laura Lee, James Charles, take your pick and save you some money. Okay, so after I do my shadow, what I then move on to is I go ahead and conceal, which I've already went over that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go right into contour. So I typically, because I do use a cream contour, I go ahead, I'll do my concealer, let it set, and while it sets, I go ahead and move on to my contour, which for contour, I use the Chanel bronzer. Now this really is a really flawless bronzer, contour, whatever you use it for. It's very natural, very airbrush. All these products that I'm speaking of, unless I have like multiples, I'm wearing. So Jacqueline Hill palette on the eyes, of course the brow products, all that's on me right now. This is the bronzer that I'm wearing. I have Kevin Kwan concealer, by the way. This is the contour that I use every single day. I've probably had this for about 3 months now, maybe 4, and it's not even, I mean, you can still see the original like swirls in the top there. And just a little tip from one shopper to the next, if you do want to add this to your makeup collection and you're willing to splurge the $50, I'm telling you that it is so worth it. It is so beautiful and just natural. It just looks so natural, just like you're naturally, I don't know. It's gorgeous. So if you go on the Chanel website, if you're like me and you can't go on the Chanel website and just buy yourself a $6,000-$7,000 handbag, but you want the Chanel experience, order this on the Chanel website instead of Sephora or Nordstrom or whatever. It's going to be the same price regardless of where you buy it. But if you order on the Chanel site, you get a Chanel box. It comes with the Chanel paper, with the Chanel sticker, with the Chanel flower. And it's just nice to get a, you know, Chanel package in the mail. And you can just, you know, every time you have to go and get you another one, you can just collect you some Chanel boxes. So this is definitely the contour for me. So I am skipped over my face oil and my primer. So we're gonna go ahead and cut back a little bit here. And we're going to go ahead and start out with face oil because that's typically what I do. I didn't even talk about my foundation, so I'm just all over the place here, guys. So I typically always use a face oil on my face before I put on foundation because I do have really dry skin. So I've searched high and low. I am a face oil connoisseur. I do like the Smashbox face oil a lot, but I found one that I am going to mix that I do like better, and I would recommend to you before I would Smashbox, and that is the Wander Beauty. I'm sorry, it's dirty, guys. Everything that I'm showing you may be dirty, but that's because it's used, so that should just prove to you more that I know what I'm talking about here. So this is the Glow Ahead Illuminating Face Oil by Wander Beauty. This is the best face oil I have ever used. It does not make you feel like an oil slick. It is not shiny at all. It is, I don't know if the camera's gonna pick it up, but if you can see there in the tube, it is like a pink shimmer, but it does not leave shimmer on your face at all. It is just the best face oil I've ever used. So if you have dry skin, or you have trouble, you know, blending out your concealer because your underneath your eyes are dry, this is a beautiful, beautiful face oil that is worth every cent. Like, I could not go without this. Now, as far as Holy Grail, like my favorite face primer, like end of the day, I do have several over here, but I am going to discuss like my all-time favorite. Again, I have dry skin, so I do like a moisturizing primer, but even more than that, I like a primer that is tacky. If a primer is tacky, to me, that says that my makeup is not going anywhere and it's going to stay put. And for me, this is my favorite. So this is the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. I love this primer so I'm trying not to show you all my grimy nails, but this is my favorite primer regardless. Now, I am going to say I ordered a mini of the Cover FX primer, setting powder, and setting spray, just because I really just wanted to try the setting powder because I heard Jaclyn Hill talk about how great it was. And she was right. I ended up ordering a full size, and we're going to talk about it here in a minute, but I ended up falling in love with the primer too. So I do want to just give this one a shout out because this one has moved high up on the ranks. Now today, underneath this space is the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. Excuse me, guys. But I did want to mention this one. This is the Cover FX Water Cloud Primer. This is just the mini. I do have the full size on its way. It's just not made it here yet. So I did want to give it a shout out though, because it is so good. It's tacky. It's a moisturizing primer, and I absolutely love it. So, foundation. I did want to mention two different types of foundation. I wanted to mention a matte foundation, which is my preference, and I wanted to mention a Lumi foundation as well. So I have, again, several foundations over here, which are really good, but there are two that stand out to me when it comes to all-time favorites. So, as I already said, matte foundation is my preference. This is a huge influence of Sister James Charles himself, and this is the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. This is in my tan shade, warm beige. It's the foundation I'm wearing right now. This is the most full coverage, flawless foundation, and for anybody out there really that wants to try foundation, but they're like, oh, well, it's full coverage or medium coverage, this one is technically medium to full. But if you were to add a little bit of moisturizer to a foundation, it will thin out the coverage. So if you did want to try foundation, but you're like, okay, that's a little bit too full coverage, or you bought a foundation and it's more full coverage than you thought, and you really don't want to deal with the hassle of sending it back or what have you, you can always add a little bit of moisturizer. So this is my all-time favorite matte foundation. And if we're talking Lumi, if we're talking like a glowy foundation, that's also full coverage, because I am a full coverage queen. It is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Luminous Foundation. This is in the shade 310C. Again, this is my spray tan shade, and I love this if I'm in the mood for like that glowy look. This is my absolute favorite Lumi foundation. I think they killed it with this formula, because I have found that the main issue that I've had with luminous foundations, I've had a little bit of issues with like blending for some reason, and I haven't tried very many. I've tried two, and The one that comes to mind the most is Luminous Silk Foundation. And my issue there is it gets into my smile lines within an hour. And within an hour, I'm like left with like crease. So this is killing the game. I love the look. It looks flawless. It lasts. It stays. It doesn't budge. Boom. Okay, so we already did Tatte Contour. We already did Tatte Concealer. So moving right along to, let's do bronzer. So for bronzer, I've also ordered another one of these. This is actually from Holiday, but this is the Morphe. This is the Glamabronze Megastar Bronzer, and I'm here to tell you that this is a dupe for the Marc Jacobs Coconut Bronzer. Again, I've had this since Holiday. This is how much has been used. It looks like it's barely been touched, but it's been used almost every single day. It's on my face right now. I have the Marc Jacobs bronzer and it's gorgeous, but if you can get basically the same thing with this huge of a pan, which the Marc Jacobs one is a huge pan as well, I will say, but this is literally probably a quarter of the price, so just saying, this is my favorite. This is the one that I grab the most. Now, for blush, I am going to mention my two favorites. I'm going to mention one with more of a sheen to it, and I am going to mention my favorite matte bronzer. Now, I will say that this will be my favorite matte bronzer, but you can find this shade, I'm sure, with ColourPop for a fraction of the cost. However, the MAC formula for me, when it comes to blushes, when it comes to bronzers, when it comes to their powders, it's just awesome. So this is the MAC blush in the shade Hushabye. So this is it right here. I'm wearing it right now. It's so beautiful. You can build it up to be as bright as the pan, or you can dip your brush in one or two times and have what you see right here. I just love a mauve tone blush. That is my absolute favorite. I feel like it complements my skin tone and my eyes the most. So I did want to mention this blush right here. And then as far as a blush with more of a sheen to it, I feel like there is no other blush. I mean, there's the Ciate blushes, but I don't like them as much as these. This is the Hourglass Diffused in the shade Diffused Heat. This is the Ambient Lighting Blush. And these are like so beautiful. I have them in four different shades and I love them all. This is more of a peachy tone, but it is absolutely beautiful. And I have heard a lot of people that have been like scared of getting these because they are afraid that it is like more highlighty than I guess it looks, but no, it's not at all. So I did want to share, this is my absolute favorite blush that I do have. And on to highlight. So for highlight, we have three different options we're going to discuss. We're going to discuss my favorite, all-time favorite highlighting kit or palette. We're also going to discuss my favorite loose highlight, and we're going to discuss my like favorite highlight. So starting with loose highlight, we are going to discuss the Artist Couture. This is the Diamond Glow Powder in the shade Summer Haze. It is what I'm wearing today. And these are so pigmented. Honey, you could see them from outer space. If you're standing on the moon, you could see me down here. They are so beautiful. They're beautiful as shadows. They're, of course, beautiful as highlights. They are gorgeous. Now, my favorite all-time highlight, which I'm not sure why I grabbed the mini. I actually ordered this on accident. I needed another one, and I ordered the mini on accident. I did not mean to order this little bitty guy, but it's just me using it, so it will last forever. But this, of course, is the Becca Champagne Pop. I just feel like Jaclyn Hill is gorge. If she told me, okay, Morgan, if you go and you rub your face against an elephant's butt, and you'll have flawless, beautiful, you know, skin, I would go. I'm just going to admit that right now. And this changed the game, I believe, in the industry, period, for all beauty gurus, what have you when it comes to collabs and everything else. This changed the game. Champagne Pop is the most, I would say, the top highlighter rank for me when it comes to weddings, when it comes to proms. I think that this is the most beautiful highlight that can be photographed, can be filmed. It transfers in the light beautifully, so I had to mention this one because it is an all-time favorite of mine. And then as far as my favorite highlight palette, this is by Laura Lee Los Angeles. This is in the shade Glazed. This is her lit kit. It does come in two different shades. You can get bronze or you can get glazed. So if you are light to medium skin tone, you can get the glazed here. And it does come, as long as this palette is, there is a full-on mirror in here. And I love it because it's strong enough to where it can set up, it kind of set up itself. So as long as you have just a little something for it to kind of set on, it can set up and you can like touch up your makeup or whatever. I mean, just imagine, I don't want to blind you all, but this whole thing right here is a mirror. And the shades, let's talk about the shades. So here are the shades right here. Let me actually not show you all upside down. So here are the shades right here. I have diamonds right here, right now in my inner corner and on my brow bone. I use that pretty much every single day on my brow bone and inner corner. It's my favorite for there. I would say Glow Gal, the next one over, the more champagne-y shade, is my favorite. I do love Rosé All Day, just to like, if you don't want to even wear a blush and just use this highlight, it's gorgeous. And then the Cinnamon Sugar is a little dark for me, but I use it as an eyeshadow and it is beautiful with like a pretty brown eyeshadow look, and then put that Cinnamon Sugar in the middle. So pretty. It's beautiful. These are extremely, extremely pigmented. They are super, super duper fairly priced. I mean, just honestly, I believe when I got them, I got this one and the bronzed and liquid lip, and it was all under $50. I'll tell you that right now. And typically, if you go to the Laura Lee Los Angeles site, she typically always has like bundle deals. So yeah, this palette right here is bomb diggity. So I'm going to go ahead and mention my setting powders. I use a setting powder, and then I used one to kind of brighten up the under eye. But as I mentioned earlier, Jaclyn Hill, Influence, again, Elephant's Foot, I would go. She mentioned this several times, and I've been looking for like the best setting powder, like the one that changes the game, blah, blah, blah. She mentioned this is the perfect setting powder, and I 100% agree. I just love this setting powder. It is so finely milled. It literally almost feels as if nothing, like if you were to, like there's a little extra on my lid here, it literally almost feels as if nothing's on your fingers. This is so beautiful. Of course, I set my eyes with it today, and as far as cutting underneath your bronzer, it does the best job ever. I love it. This is in the shade Light Translucent. It's amazing. Now, for brightening powder, I will say that I love the Nikita Dragon face palette, but unfortunately, I do not have it here with me. So I did want to mention that one though, because I do use it just as much as the one I'm about to mention. Her brightening powder is top of the line game changer, but one that was heavily influenced me by Manny anyway is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish, and this is in the shade Fair One. I love this. You can see that it's clearly loved. I've already hit pan, but I use it every single day, and I've probably had it for probably 3 to 4 months now. But I love this stuff. It's under my eyes today. It's just, I have to have a brightening powder. I have to. So those are my favorites. Now, moving right along, I think now we are ready for the final step. So we'll go ahead and mention the eyeliner and mascara. So for eyeliner and mascara, there is one that I use. I feel like if it ain't broke, don't fix it. For the liner, I use the Hank and Henry Stick With It liner in the shade Blickety Black. It's what's on my eyes today. It's matte. It's beautiful. It lasts forever. This literally lasts forever. It says it's good for 6 months. It's lasting longer, so cheers. But yeah, I love this liner. I haven't found one that I like more. It's bomb. Now for mascara, this is huge influence of Bailey Sarian here on YouTube. She mentioned this. I heard her mention it several times and I was like, I'm gonna try it. And I've never bought another mascara. It's literally $4.99, whether you buy it on Ulta, whether you buy it on Amazon, it's $4.99. This is the Essence Lash Princess Mascara. It's the waterproof one. It is in the shade black. I will show you the lash, the mascara wand, because so many people always say, well, you didn't show me the mascara wand. It gets in there good, especially if you wear falsies like me. It helps blend. I love this mascara. It does not budge. But when I go in with my micellar water at the end of the day, there's no problem taking it off my eyes. I love this mascara. Now, go ahead with lashes. I'm going to mention two different ones. We'll go ahead and mention the, I guess, more expensive ones. Now, I will let you know, I have a pair of Lily lashes right there. My preferred style is Miami. If I'm talking Lily lashes, which obviously they are a favorite of mine, they are gorgeous. However, now these have been worn once. This is also influence of Bailey Sarian here on YouTube. She done her filming room tour and she had a whole drawer full of these and she pulled them out and I was like, those are gorgeous. These are Bold Face Beauty and these are in the style Mega Babe. They are gorgeous. I only ordered two pair just because I wanted to see how I felt about them. I love them. I have six more on the way. They are super duper affordable, like $8-$9. Like you can't beat it with a stick. And they are so beautiful. They're easy to clean as well, which I like about a lash. That is very important to me. Now, if you're looking for a good like Lily Lash type dupe on a budget, I order these every time I run out just because they're good to have and they're beautiful lashes. I'm wearing them right now. You can get these on Amazon for $11. They are by Valicia and these are in the style Dubai. So I'm going to leave this on the screen a minute in case you want to screenshot or whatever. And then on the back, there is their social media and you can see there on the bar underneath the barcode, you can see the style Dubai there. I don't want to show my nails. They are gross. But yeah, these are from Amazon and they are absolutely stunning. I've not had any issues with them. I can rewear them. I typically only rewear them maybe 3 times, if that. If I'm being honest, I probably wear them either 1 or 2 times, just depending on how gross they do get. So we've got two more categories to go here. We've got lips and we've got setting spray. So for lips, I'm gonna go ahead and do my favorite liner. Now, I do love MAC liners in general, but I don't have them right here nearby me, but I love Strip Down by MAC. That's my all-time favorite. That is on my lips right now, but it's in the other room. But MAC lip liners are top-notch. Now, I do want to mention, these are the NYX Suede Liners, and I just recently discovered these. This is in Whipped Caviar. I have 2 different shades on their way to me right now. These are gorgeous. They glide on like butter. Whatever lip that you want, I don't know, something about the lip just kind of melts into these lip liners. I wanted to give these a shout out because these are under $4 and they perform like they're $25. So I had to mention this lip liner here. Now, also for liquid lips, I'm going to mention 3. I'm going to mention the shade that I've been wearing a lot this month, and that is by Laura Lee Los Angeles. This is in the shade Coral Pop. And this is just so beautiful. It just is so, my nails. Thanks, niece. but it's just such a beautiful shade, like springy time, just pretty. If you just want to do like a real natural eye and you want to do a pop of color, this is just the way to go. I love, love, love this shade. Now, I'm going to do my favorite higher end liquid lip, and I'm going to do my favorite, I guess, you know, lower priced. I don't want to say lower end because it's not, but lower priced liquid lip. So my favorite high end liquid lip is by Anastasia. I love their formula. I think it's beautiful. It lasts forever. It does not feel like, you know, it's, I hate when you put a liquid lipstick on and your lips feel like you have been laying in the middle of the desert in the middle of summer with the heat and the sun just beaming down on your lips for 4 days. You ain't had no water. I hate when a liquid lipstick makes you feel like that. Like, that is the worst feeling ever. These do not. And this is my favorite shade. This is Pure Hollywood. It is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful nude. And I absolutely love this shade. It is my favorite. Now, I'm not going to say lower end. I'm going to say more affordable liquid lip, because this is not a low end brand. Obviously, it's a very big favorite of mine. I've mentioned it already several times. But this is by ColourPop. I love their liquid lipsticks. They are gorgeous, they are affordable, and they are not drying. They stay. I'm gonna touch up if I eat. I think I'm not an animal, but you know, if I really didn't want to, I could get by. So, and this is my favorite shade that I've been wearing a lot here lately, and that is Times Square. And yeah, so those are my liquid lips. So I think the last thing we have here is setting spray, and I'm going to mention two. So the one that I use the most, now it doesn't necessarily have to be the Jeffree Star collab. I just have this one because it was strawberry, and I was like, shoot, I want my face to smell like strawberries. So I got this one, and it's just like the Morphe Setting Refreshed. It just smells like strawberries. It is the same formula. It performs the same. This stuff is holy grail. Morphe killed it with this setting spray. Morphe kills it with a lot. What are we talking about? Don't sleep on Morphe. Don't do that. Why would you do that? Why would you sleep on Morphe? And a setting spray that I just recently discovered. And I actually had a friend of mine who also was into makeup. She messaged me and she was like, hey, I found a dupe for MAC Fix Plus. And I was like, really? I was like, by who? And she was like, CoverGirl. And I was like, no way. And she was like, girl, I swear. She was like, have you ever bought the MAC Fix Plus, like the rose scent? And I was like, yes, that's my favorite one. She said, go on Ulta right now and order this setting spray. And so she sent me the link. I ordered it. We got us a dupe on our hands, people. This is the CoverGirl Clean and Fresh Prep and Set. Yeah, Prep and Set Water Mist. This is in the scent Rose. It smells just like the Rose MAC Fix Plus, and it literally almost seems like the exact same formula. I've used it every single day. I've went out in the heat. I have done it all, and this is really, really good. Really, really good. It really, really shocked me. So yeah, guys, those are all of my Holy Grails products. If I'm going to a deserted island, these are all coming with me. If I am, the house is down, I'm grabbing as much as I can and running out the door. So I wanted to share all of these with you. I do also want to say here at the end of this that if you haven't already, please do subscribe to my channel. I'm so excited to start interacting with you guys. The more of you all that do come along, I'm getting just so excited for all the love, the support, and just positivity that has been shared in the comments and just between one another. That is just awesome, 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 possum, and I'm just so excited. So please do subscribe if you haven't already. And if you do subscribe, do make sure that you do turn your notification bell on. That way you can be notified anytime that I do post. I am new, which means I am irrelevant. So if you don't have your notification bell turned on, you more than likely will not know that I've posted. And always, you know, comment down below what you do want to see, any video ideas or something that you just are like, I would like to see that. I'm up to any suggestions. I'm down for whatever. And if you like this video and you enjoyed it, make sure that you do give it a big thumbs up. I do also want to say thank you to all the people who have already subscribed to my channel. It means absolutely more than you know. And again, I will be doing a giveaway when I do get to 100 subscribers. So let's get us there. Let's get us to 100. Let's get us to 100. Let's get us to 100. All right, guys. I love you guys so much. I hope you all enjoyed this video. And without further ado, I will see you all in the next video.